Hi and welcome to Food and Magic. In this video, let's see how to make perfect soft and round suji ke laddu or simple ravyache laddu. Despite of being soft, these laddus will hold shape as I have shared lots of details and my secret to make these perfect laddus. These laddus just melt in the mouth and are soft, moist and absolutely yummy. So before we begin, if you like this video, do press the like button and subscribe to my channel for more such interesting recipes. So let's get started with today's recipe. The first important thing is correct amount of ingredients. Here I'm taking 3 cups of suji and 1 cup of ghee. I'm using the finest of suji, which is a 0 number, which is very fine in texture. To measure these ingredients, you can use a measuring cup or any katori in your house and measure all the ingredients with the same katori. In a heavy bottom pan, add the ghee. If you are using the ready-made ghee, do not use the liquid ghee which floats on the top. Take semi-thick ghee and melt it, measure 1 cup and use that. And I shall explain the reason for this further in the video. Add all the suji at once to the ghee and start roasting it on very low flame. This process will approximately take about 40 to 45 minutes. Keep the flame low so that the color does not change and yet the suji will be roasted well. It is okay if the suji turns a little pink in color. It's been 40 minutes and the suji has become very aromatic. I will put off the flame and next, let's prepare the sugar syrup. To prepare the sugar syrup, measure sugar with the same bowl you measured the ghee and suji. Take 2 cups of sugar and add enough water till all the sugar soaks in well with the water. Here I'm using 1.5 cups of water. Bring this to a boil and make the syrup of 1 string consistency. Once the syrup comes to a good boil, first it will be very thin in consistency. Cook on medium flame for the next 4 to 5 minutes. Take a drop of the sugar syrup on a plate and leave it for 30 seconds as when it is hot, the syrup is very thin. After cooling, you can know the correct consistency. After 30 seconds, if a single string is forming between your fingers, it is perfect as we want for these laddus. Can you see the single string formed? Yes, this is the perfect consistency now. Turn off the flame and add the syrup to the roasted suji mixture. Add a teaspoon of cardamom powder and mix everything well together. At this stage, the mixture will be very thin. But that's the trick to make soft and moist laddus. Many a times these laddus become rock hard and the suji too does not become very soft. With this technique explained further, you will make laddus like a pro. When everything is mixed well, cover and leave it for 2 hours at room temperature. After 2 hours, the suji has soaked up a lot of syrup. The timing of this mixture thickening depends upon the season too. If the weather is cold, the mixture will set soon. As I'm down south, the weather is still warm. Remember I told you not to use the ghee floating on top of the store-bought packets? Because the rest of the ghee is semi-solid, this ghee takes a lot of time to set and the laddus do not hold shape. Coming back to this recipe, the mixture is very soft and if made into laddus at this stage, they will not hold shape. I'll keep this mixture in the refrigerator for 30 minutes. Can you see the difference in the texture now? The mixture has become dry and the ghee too has thickened. For this perfect texture, always melt a semi-thick ghee and then use it in this recipe. These are the small tips which will help you make perfect laddus. At this stage, add dry fruits of your choice and mix well. You can rewind the video and see the difference in the texture too. This suji is moist, soft and yet very dry. When you roll the laddus, they will hold shape when kept at room temperature. The mixture is mixed well, now let's roll the laddus. I'm rolling big laddus, so taking a big portion as these laddus are loved a lot in my home. With the measurement shown in today's video, you can make approximately 20 laddus of medium to big size. Just roll between the palms for the round shape and here the laddu is ready. Decorate it whichever way you like it. As like I say every time, the food not only should taste good but it should look good too. I And here our first laddu is ready. I will roll rest of the laddus and store them in a tight steel box up to 7 days at room temperature. These laddus are perfectly round and are so soft that they will just melt in the mouth. Hope you liked today's video. Do try out this recipe. I would love to know your feedback in the comment section given down below. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon with a new video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.